Good morning, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, wherever you are. May God bless you and may God be with you. Our meditation for today is key number 4, which is the key of faith. And to help us with the meditation, let's look at Matthew chapter 17, verse 19 to 20. The disciples approached Jesus in private and said, "Why could we not drive it out?" He said to them, "Because of your little faith. Amen, I say to you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you say to this mountain, 'Move from here to there,' and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you." This was after Jesus had healed the boy whom the disciples could not heal. Before healing this boy, Jesus had gone to the mountain where he was transfigured, and after the transfiguration, Jesus came down and found a crowd of people, and when they joined the crowd, the father of the boy approached him and told him, "Please, Master, I brought this boy to your disciples. They could not cure the boy. But now, have mercy on my son. He has been sick and he has epilepsy. Sometimes when he gets attacks, he's thrown into fire. Sometimes he's thrown into the water. So please do something for him." And when Jesus prayed, the boy was cured. So the disciples went privately to ask him, "But why couldn't we, Master?" And then he told them, "If only you had faith the size of a mustard seed." He did not ask them for faith the size of a mango seed or an avocado seed or the seed that we know, tangible seeds that we know, the big seeds that we know. He just asked them for the size of a mustard seed. Just a little is what the Lord is asking us today. A size of a mustard seed, just a little faith, a little confidence in him, a little trust, just a little is what the Lord told them to have, and is why it is the same that he's telling us today. The biblical definition of faith, according to Hebrews chapter 11 verse 3, the verse 1, Hebrews 11 verse 1, it says, "Faith means being sure of the things we hope for and knowing that something is real." Being sure of the things we hope for and knowing that something is real. Faith, according to me, according to my experience, according to my understanding, and according to what I've gone through, I define faith as follows. Faith is the ability to let go of the control button. Faith, it is the ability to be comfortable not knowing. My personality is being structured and organized. I'm a perfectionist. So when you have my type of personality, not knowing makes you uncomfortable. It freaks you out. Because not knowing disturbs your timetable, disturbs your... Because when you're unstructured, even if you don't know anything, you still progress with whatever you want to do. But when you're structured like me, if you don't know, it disturbs your thinking, because when you're structured, you even think in a structured way. So if you don't know something, it disturbs you because you don't know where to fix it. So when you have faith in God, you become comfortable not knowing. So sometimes God allows certain situations that he will ask him, "God, when will this happen? How will it happen? In which way?" And God will be quiet because he does not want you to know. So it is being comfortable not knowing, which is not easy for some of us. But if you want to trust God, you need to be comfortable not knowing. And faith is the ability to relax in the midst of a storm, or in the midst of a change of program, change of timetable. I will speak from my experience. A change of timetable for me was something that would really disturb. It can even disturb my whole day, even if I don't speak about it, but I would be disturbed. a change of program. Maybe if we are told today, well, these prayers should take 1 hour or should take 1 hour, 30 minutes. And the moment it is 1 hour and I'm physically aware or mentally aware that it has reached 1 hour, then my mind switches off automatically because it is 1 hour. Instead of listening, whether it's a teaching or preaching, I will begin to ask myself, why is this person taking so long? Don't they know that it is already 1 hour? Don't they know that they said we have to leave 5 minutes before breakfast? Don't they know that we have to do this? Don't they know that we have to do this? Because my mind is structured and I'm a structured person. But when it comes to God, God teaches you how to be able to relax in the midst of storm, in the midst of a change of program, in the midst of a change of timetable, in the midst of uncertainty. Because as God is in charge, He leads and directs us in different ways. So He's asking us to have faith in His operations, to have faith in what He does. Sometimes you may be a programs coordinator and then this facilitator comes late and this or even does not show up at all. But when your faith is so little, you freak out, you'll be disturbed because things don't, or people don't show up on time. When you are structured, you struggle and it becomes hard. But when you have confidence in God, even when things don't start according to the program, you still be relaxed. You not panic. You not freak out. It's okay to be organized. It's okay to be structured. It's okay to be on time. It's okay to want things to run. But there are times that God allows things to just start according to His time. He disorganizes things to reorganize them according to His program, according to His timetable. So faith is the ability to relax. Even in the midst of God's reorganization, when God begins to reorganize, disorganize and reorganize things, you are capable of relaxing. Faith is the ability to dethrone yourself from the leadership position and allowing God to take a lead role. Faith is also the ability to be comfortable when God plays a body double role in your life. A body double is where, like in the movies that we watch, we have the main characters, and some of those main characters, the people playing the role of a main character, sometimes don't know how to do certain things. Like maybe if they are to sing, they don't know how to sing, or they don't know how to dance, or they don't know how to fight. So they are going to bring a body double, a person that they are going to dress up exactly like the main character, or sometimes they even make them wear masks so that they look the same as the actual person playing the role. So this person will do on behalf of the main character the things that they are not capable of doing. If this main character does not know how to dance, when it reaches the part for dancing, this person will dance for them or fight for them or even sing for them or play an instrument for them. They will pick someone who knows that or who's a profession in that area. So even God does that. There are certain areas, things that we are not good at. So let's allow God to play the body double on our behalf, so that because he's an expert, he's experienced in all areas, he's experienced in everything. Instead of stressing out, instead of freaking out, let's allow God to take that place. Let's allow God to let's be comfortable when God is doing it for us. Let's be comfortable when God is in charge, when God is doing it. Because there are times that maybe you have studied, like I've done accounts and I know how to run a business, and I know how you can make profits and how you can also make losses. And even when I'm doing business, because right now I'm running a stationery shop as well as doing some baking side by side. So there are times that for the past few months, I've been in charge, trying to organize, seeing how I can maximize on profits and all that. But I think for the past 2 weeks or so, I just told God, I think I can't do this anymore. I may be good at accounts, at maths, but I think this is time for you to play the body double, take charge and be in charge. I'm letting go and I'm allowing you to just be in charge and run this business on my behalf. Do it for me. I don't know how you are going to do it. I don't know where people are going to come from, but I just know that you are going to do it for me. Just employ me and I'll be your employee and be my employer, and I'm letting go. And from the moment I said that, from the day I said that, though there was still something in me that wanted to keep holding on, but from the moment I said that, things have changed, the business has improved. I don't know where customers come from, but I just know that it is God connecting his own customers to the business. And I've learned to even surrender all other areas of my life, my spirituality, where I'll try to be in charge, where I'll try to organize my own prayer time. It is good, but I learned to relax. I've also learned how to pray and not cling to the prayer points or not be consumed by what I'm asking God for. Like, for example, I may ask God to give me a life partner. It's not something that I should cling on to say. The first thing I think about when I go to sleep and the first thing I think about when I wake up, but I've learned to pray and surrender and let go. Allowing God to take place, allowing God to have a lead role. Faith does not stop pain from coming. It does not stop struggles. It does not stop hardships, but it helps you stand in the face of that. It gives you the confidence to smile. It gives you the stamina to keep moving on, even when you have gone through a lot. And faith is not a feeling, but it is a decision that one makes. You decide to have faith in God. You don't feel like it, you don't sense like it, or you don't visualize it. So may God renew our faith today. May God, especially some of us who might have gone through so much that we've prayed, nothing has happened, we fasted, may God revive our faith. May we give God a second chance to trust him, just a little bit of that. May we be able to give God a second chance. Let's trust him. Let's allow him again to take his rightful position in our lives. May God bless all of us. May our faith be increased through the power of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' most holy name, amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.